happy Janmashtami, guys. May Lord Krishna bestow on you all his blessings. So, you know, Janmashtami has always been a festival I was, you know, very enthusiastic about since I was a kid. So when I was a kid, I used to go watch Matki Phor. I used to make a small village of my own, like the village where Lord Krishna was born, and people in my locality, they used to come, they used to give me 10-20 rupees on that temple, and it was pretty lit. I mean, I used to feel so great. So yeah, since that time, I was a fan. So, you know, Lord Krishna, I feel so attached to the sayings of Bhagavad Gita because we don't have rules to follow Hinduism. But yeah, Bhagavad Gita teaches a lot on how to live a life as a better human being and as a better Hindu. So yeah, Lord Krishna has taught us a lot. Necessary that you need to fast in order to connect to God. But if you feel you can, you should. And also that when you fast, it, you know, cleanses your soul and also it cleanses your body to some extent. And also, since people, you know, try this modern concept of intermittent fasting these days, so why not fast in a traditional way? I thought that, so I tried it. And moreover, you can eat fruits and coffee and, you know, basic falahar you can do. So I did that. So it was good. So now it's like the evening time. Now I'll pray and then I'll eat. How my mom is, you know, decorated the temple, and here he is, little Kanhaji, and you know, you can literally move the swing, and it's so good, you know. And this is another Kanhaji, so yeah, happy birthday, Lord Krishna Pita Mahadev. Pumpkin and this peanut chutney, kuttu ki roti and aloo ki sabzi to break it up. Since we all celebrate Janmashtami, so what as an individual do we learn from Lord Krishna? First of all, he was a person who was very down to earth and he was always there for people who need him, especially his friends. So when Sudhama, as we all know, he came and, you know, he had just 3 muthi chawal with him, so Lord Krishna in turn gave him a lot. So yes, Lord Krishna teaches us that. Secondly, it, as said in Bhagavad Gita, the shloka as says, Karmanye vadhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana ma karma phal hetu bhurma te sangostva karmani. So this means that, you know, we should always keep on doing our work and we should not think about the result. And obviously, if we put in our efforts, the result would be good for sure. Lord Krishna respected women because when Draupadi, she was being molested by the Kauravas, nobody came to her rescue but Lord Krishna did. So that means he knew what, you know, the sanctity of a woman is. So for all the people who don't know Hindu mythology and comment that, you know, Shri Krishna had a lot of gopis after him, it was not like that. It was just he was, and also that, you know, the point he was I should say what I have analyzed, that he used to do Ras Leela, which is a form of dance, and in Vrindavan they celebrated as a form of dance. So as a male person, he used to pursue dance. So since that time, he believed in equality of men and women. So yeah, he taught us that too. With whatever Lord Krishna has taught us, let's pledge that this Janmashtami we become better humans and be good to each other and do our work and put in our efforts, and obviously God would bestow all his blessings on us and we will get the result.